If you're using Project Broadcast landing pages in your business, and especially if you're creating a lot of them, then you definitely want to check out these hacks to help you save some time. My name is Julie Godshall, and I use PBLPs heavily. I've created a lot of templates for people in my program, SparkHub, because SparkHub can come in and help you create PBLPs that act as sign-up pages and what we call party pages to help you run your events with a lot of your content automated and tied to that event. So I want to share my favorite secrets that I've discovered along the way through creating a lot of these. Let's start simple. Hack number one is to copy your content. You may already know this, but I find that a lot of people don't know about this great little feature. Let's say I've created a button and it's in the colors I want, the font I want. I've even added some rounding to the borders. Great. Now I want to have matching buttons throughout my page. There's no need to create a fresh button and recreate this styling. I can instead select it, and you can see here that I have the option to duplicate it. So I'll now duplicate it and then grab right here to drag it anywhere on the page that I want it to go. From there, I can of course edit the label and destination as needed. So you can duplicate any single element in this way, or you can go a little further out and select the entire row of content and duplicate the row. The row can contain multiple columns and multiple pieces of content. And you can see that I have a duplication option here as well to duplicate the entire row or block of content. And that leads me to my second hack. The second hack is similar, but instead of just duplicating something on your page, it lets you duplicate content across multiple pages. And that's through saving blocks. So you can see here, now that I have selected the entire row or block of content, I have this third option. So in addition to deleting or duplicating, I can save it. A great example of a block you may want to reuse on a different page is a footer. So perhaps you've created a footer containing your contact info, your social channels, and this could be handy to use on another page. So I'm going to save it. I can select a category and I can create tags that help make it easier to search later. So now this footer area is saved in my sort of library of frequently used blocks. So what's next? How do I make use of this? Well, if I open any PBLP in my account, I can go to add a block. And here I have some built-in blank options, but I also have my saved blocks available here for me. So I can find the category or search for the category or a tag to find it. And then I can just drag it onto my page. My next hack is a way to save time when you're adding images to your page, and that is through using image URLs to add images. When you add an image to your page and you click on it, you have a few options. You can upload an image, you can drag an image in, you can search stock images. But what about this image URL? So here's a fun fact. Almost every image you see out on the internet that you could just download to your device and then upload into Project Broadcast actually has a unique URL associated with it. Great example of this and a great use case is something like product images. Maybe you want to feature some shoppable thumbnails. Just go to your shopping site, right-click on the image that you want to use, and copy the image URL. Back in your design screen for your landing page, you can paste that in as the image URL, and boom, there's your photo. There is no need to download it to your device and clutter up your storage. You can even apply effects to it, like cropping it to the dimensions that you want to use. Also, here's another fun fact. You can even use the image URL for a GIF, such as a link at giphy.com. Now here are a couple of warnings. Warning number one is, let's say you're viewing the image on a private page. Maybe it's an area you had to log into in order to access that image. Well, I can't guarantee that that image is going to be publicly viewable. I don't know behind the scenes of how it's stored on that website. And so I would stick with images that are on publicly viewable sites and always test your work. My next warning is that even though these images usually seem to stick around forever, I can't guarantee you that they will. And so there's a chance that the owner of the website that it lives on will wipe out that image from the database. And so that will break your link. So just use this with caution if you're going to have an image on there for a long, long, long time. Just keep in mind that unlike uploading an image where you're creating a new copy of it that will live on the PBLP, you are instead letting the viewer of your page see an image that actually lives elsewhere on a page that you don't control, unless, of course, you are the owner of the original page that the image is on. My next hack to save time is to embed a Canva design into your PBLP. Now, usually when I recommend this, it's because embedding Canva designs lets you add some visual interest and some interactivity, add some more content without actually adding extra vertical bulk to your page. And that's all true. But there's also a time-saving aspect to embedding a Canva design, because if you want to update your content over time and you want that content to live on multiple pages, well, if you're embedding from Canva, then you only have to update in one place in your Canva design, because then that update is going to show up everywhere that it's embedded. I have a separate video giving you all the details of how to embed a Canva design if this is new to you or if you run into issues. So think about if you have some uses for this trick. So one example would be, maybe you have multiple landing pages that all feature your current specials, and those specials change every month. Well, every time the specials change, you don't want to have to go into each of those pages and update with a new image. You can centralize the process. Create a single Canva design. It can just be a simple one-page design that just contains the specials, and then you can embed that across all of those pages. Now you only have to update in one place. My final time-saving tip is my favorite, because it is just one of the ideas that led to the creation of SparkHub itself. And it's to use project broadcast landing pages for events and automate your content by using SparkHub magic. The most obvious case for this SparkHub magic, which is what I call our HTML code blocks, is to run a direct sales event using PBLPs. You can have similar content from one event to the next on a signup page that people will see when they've been invited, and on what we call a party page, which is a page with logistical info and other content for guests to see. But you want to customize these pages, of course, with information about the event. You want it to reference the host by name, have key dates showing that the guests can add to their calendar, even welcome the guests by name and interact with them through the event. With SparkHub, you can enter your event information into one place, and then SparkHub does the rest. SparkHub makes sure that your signup page and your party page are fully updated with the information about your event. But that's only the start, because we'll even help to manage your texting strategy with the content of those texts also updated for your event, your to-do lists, your host resources, and even your customer follow-up plan. To see how this all comes together, be sure to check out our demo at sparkhub.app/demo, where you can even join a mock event to see how this looks from a guest point of view. So to recap, save time. You can duplicate content across a single page to avoid having to format multiple times. You can save blocks for use across multiple pages to avoid having to recreate them. Add images using the image URL trick so you don't have to download and upload images to and from your device. Use an embedded Canva design so you can make updates in just one spot that will result in updated info across multiple sites. And use SparkHub so you can create signup pages and event pages with all the info they need with no actual editing required. What'd you think of this video? Is there a tip that you plan to try? I'd love to hear it in the comments, and I'll see you next time.